Good evening. Hi, St. Max. How you doing? Hi, Virginia. You right, lovely? Hi, Anne. Hello, Jane. Hi, Magdalena. Good evening, my lovelies. Hi, Dawn. Good to see you. Hi, everybody else. Your name may not come up, but you might be watching, but hello to you. Hi, Emma. Hi, Pete. Greetings from South Wales. Hello. Hi, Sue. Good evening, my love. Hi, Elaine. Good evening, everybody. It's Saturday night again. Hello, Richard. Good to see you, mate. Hi, Keith and Anne. Hi, Maria Eleanor. Good evening. And good evening to everybody. Well, it's lovely, lovely names popping up. And I've got little pictures down here as well on my phone. Hey, hi, Sam. Samantha. Lovely to see you. It's been great. I was just telling a friend of mine about us doing prayers online twice a day and how the church has grown actually in that time. It's been lovely, even though we haven't actually been in the building, it's grown because there's been relationships made and contacts made online, which has been fantastic. And we've had a lovely day. And it was really rainy this morning, but we went for a walk at Cockington, which is a lovely kind of estate, very near, very kind of central Torquay. And it's beautiful, and the kids took their scooters, and we took the dog, and went for a lovely walk. And you could see dragonflies and damselflies flying around, and baby chick, more hens and ducks, and it was really lovely, and we were able to have an ice cream, so that was lovely too. And then I came back and was able to watch a really good friend of mine, Josie, on an online creativity summit, Christian creativity summit, which is run by an online store called Cheerfully Given, which is like a Christian Etsy selling forum for Christian creatives. I'm going to say hi to my lovely daddy. Hello, Dad. Reg Berry's my dad. And hey, Kev, good to see you. Yeah, so I saw my friend on this forum, and then there was a live. She did a talk about the Christian Creative Network, which we run in Torquay for the whole of this area, kind of South Devon. There's one in Tiverton and Taunton though as well. And I'm the branch leader for the Torquay one. We started about 18 months ago. Got about 150 members. It's online. You can seek us out, Christian Creative Network Torquay or CCN Torquay, and it's to encourage and equip and champion creativity in the body of Christ. And had a chat with Josie after she did this live, and it was fantastic. It's really lovely to speak to a friend. So I thought tonight we would base this on friendship and how lovely it is to be friends together. Hi, Cliff. Good to see you. Yes, welcome, Joe's dad. It's lovely. My dad does his own podcast for his church inside the M25 sort of area. I do miss you, Dad, and hopefully we'll be able to see you soon. Do miss Dad and my whole family. So, yeah, so he does his own podcast, and he had a lockdown beard that he was growing, but had to trim because it got very Father Christmassy. And my dad's sister Christine is watching as well. Hello, Christine. It's a family affair. Love it. Hi, Odette too. Nice to see you, lovely. Okay, so we're going to crack on, and we're going to begin praying. And I've got a little reflection for you from a book called Live in Grace, Walk in Love. And it's by Bob Goff, that's G-O-F-F, and it's a lovely daily devotional. Bob Goff has other books too, One called Love Does and one called Everybody Always, and they're beautiful, beautiful books. So I'd recommend them to anybody. Really easy to read, but really encouraging and exciting too. Okay, so if you've got your cup of tea or your coffee, we're going to do our simultaneous simultaneous sip to say here's to everybody and here's to getting back together again. Good evening, David. Great that you could be with us. So, cheers, everyone. Here's to when we can all be together again on church, but also here's to how lovely this is that we get to do this online. Whether you're live right now or whether this is in the future, we're with you, our hearts are with you, and our prayers are with you. So, cheers, everybody. Here's a sip. Lovely jubbly. Hi, Pauline. Hi, Chloe. Good evening, darling. Love your new hair, Chloe. Hi, Claire. Great to see you all. Okay, so let's pray. Take a deep breath, quieten your heart. And as we quite often say, Lord, recenter our scattered senses. And I know for a fact that there's a lot of people that are watching this now that have had very busy days or very tricky weeks or some really hard things going on. So let's bring this moment to God and focus. However busy we've been, whatever's been going on, let's recenter back to focusing on God. Oh Lord, we're so thankful that we have this ability and opportunity to focus on you wherever we are, whatever we're doing. Lord, that we can stop and take a breath and recenter on you. Tune into your channel, Lord. Father, please fill us. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come. Fill us up, Lord, because we need you. And Lord, I pray that the words that I read and the things that I say are from you, not from me. I pray that all the people that are watching this now or in the future are blessed by this and find peace or find some sort of revelation or grace in what has been said and what has been prayed. But Lord God, be at the center of all of this. In Jesus' holy name, amen. Okay. Hi, Anthony. Hi, Joan. Good to see you. So I'm reading from this book, and the title is "The Most Beautiful Scenery in the World is When Our Friends Come into View." And it made me think about the fact that today they've announced that in 2 weeks' time they're going to. So today is the 20th of June. In 2 weeks' time, they're going to be opening pubs and restaurants in some kind of social distancing way. We need the churches open then, don't we? Okay, just putting that out there. Not going to get political, but how can they not? How can they not? And I know that the churches, they're not silent about this. Not rolling over and doing what they're not silent about this. So, as you will have known, Sam and the team have been down at church this week preparing it for our return, socially distanced, but preparing it so it's as safe as it can be, as clean as it can be, and as distanced as it can be. And we still have to, the jury's out about singing. So, make the most of singing in your home tomorrow morning. Because tomorrow morning we've got our service at 10 o'clock, and we'll be doing some more worship. And now Sam knows what to do. We gather the words up and we have a giggle. It's so funny because you don't see what happens before I walk in the room. I'm juggling, I'm saying, kids, shush, shush, and the dog and making some food and all this. So funny. And then I walk in, sit and sing. It's so funny. I wish you could see a little fly on the wall sort of thing. There is a fly in here. I'm just telling you. Okay, let's get focused. This is what I do. It's so exciting to be with you. I get too excited. Okay, so the most beautiful scenery in the world is when our friends come into view. So from Ecclesiastes 4, verses 9 to 10, two are better than one, because they have a good return for their labour. If either of them falls down, one can help the other up. So one of the greatest miracles of living in the 21st century is how extensively we can travel. No previous generation has had the gift of being able to step on an airplane so easily, lean back for a nap, maybe not at the moment, lean back for a nap and wake up on the other side of the world. No matter where we are in the morning, by the evening we can lie on the floor of the Sistine Chapel or float in the Dead Sea. Travelling opens our eyes to see beauty in ways our grandparents couldn't have imagined. Hi, Sarah. But after a trip, as the plane touches down and we drive the last stretch home, we're reminded that the most beautiful scenery in the world is when our friends come into view. Even the best moments from our trips don't quite compare, and I'm forward thinking here, they don't quite compare to the hugs and the smiles we get when we walk through the doors of our homes and into the arms of it. I'm really looking forward to it. Boredom and discontentment spread like germs. They whisper lies to us in our daily routines, telling us we'd be happier if we could be free to go anywhere we want, whenever we want. They try to entice us with the freedom we could enjoy if only we weren't tied down by all the responsibilities that come with being invested in a community. But the strings that tie us to the people we love are the ropes that pull us up when life gets hard. Don't believe the lie that you would experience more beauty if you could only get a break from the people you're sharing your life with. The most beautiful view in the world is the sight of the faces who show up for you no matter what. Do you need to re-see the beauty in someone in your life? And that's a hard one, that's a challenge, because I know that there are people who are in hard relationships, maybe even abusive relationships, where there isn't that support and that love. But there are people who will smile and do smile, and they mean it. They're not being fake. There are people in church who do and will smile and love you and want the best for you. And I'm missing that. I'm really missing that. And I'm grateful for it. So as we move towards getting closer back to being in church and seeing each other more, you see this one face, whoever it is doing prayers, but we don't get to see you, and that's relationship and that's community, and we're so looking forward to it. So we're going to do our reimagining the examine, and I'm doing one, the examine, and I'm doing one called a relationship. I take a few deep breaths and feel myself soften and melt. Hi, Richard. Hey, Sandra. I begin to turn down my thoughts. I ask God to make his presence known, and I sense his presence around me, lingering in it. Spend a few moments in gratitude, thanking God for one or two blessings that I received today. So, looking over our recent past, I ask God to show me a person who has been on my mind and in my heart a lot. Hi, Sue. I let this person bubble up. I get a good look at this person. I hear the person's voice. I see his or her gestures, and so on. Just imagine a person that has been on your heart lately that you want to think about. I ask God why this person has been on my mind lately. I speak with him about this relationship. Lord, show us, each of us individually, who it is you want us to pray for, think about. Someone we might be missing, someone from our family or friends. It might be someone who's actually passed away and we want to remember them. Might be someone who's poorly, someone we miss. I ask God, Rich, we're going to pray for you and your dad. I ask God to reveal my strongest emotion when I reflect on my relationship with this person. Lord God, show us. Relationships are really hard sometimes, and other times they flow easily and crystal clear. But Lord, there's so much pain in certain relationships. I pray, Lord, that you would reveal to every individual where there needs to be some healing or forgiveness, where there needs to be encouragement, reconciliation, or bridges built, not destroyed. Father, I'm asking for help for people who maybe have even generational problems, where the relationship broke down generations ago, but they don't want it anymore. They want to have a refreshed and a new relationship. I pray for those who are lonely, whether they're lonely because they just find it hard to have relationships, or maybe they've lost important people. Father, be close to them. Help communities and churches to gather around them and look after them and help them know they are loved. Most of all, show your love to them. Be close, Lord Jesus. Amen. Hey, Stacy. Oh, and it's Father's Day tomorrow. It's lovely that you're watching, my dad, Reg. I miss you, and you should have received a present today or on Monday. But relationships are hard, and I can see here Richard has said, God, can you tell my dad I love him for me? Oh. Is he gone? Oh, bless you, darling. He knows. And Maria Elena, miss my dad, God, and my mum. Please give them my love. Let's use this opportunity. Send a message. Send a message. They know. God knows. God knows your thoughts before you think them. And you have my card. Well, there's a present coming too, my dad. Present coming too. Ah, Ed Williams. Okay. Will do. Okay. So move on. I get distracted. I'm so sorry. I ask God to give me an overview of my relationship with this person that I've been thinking about. Not a blow-by-blow analysis, but a quiet, contemplative summary so I can see the whole of the relationship. Lord, give us an overview to see the whole of relationship. Relationship is a two-way thing. It takes two to have a relationship, just like it takes you and me. You and us to be in relationship with you. It's not one-sided. Reveal to us, Lord, what you want us to see. So, what has this relationship meant to you? Has it led you closer to God or further away? What has been the most difficult part of being in this relationship? The most enjoyable? Is the strong emotion I'm feeling at the present moment in sync with the strong emotions I feel as I reflect on the relationship as a whole? They might not add up. I speak with and listen to God about all of this. And Lord, our emotions are powerful things, and love is overwhelming often. But there is also anger and injustice and a feeling of things being unfair sometimes. But Lord, I pray that you reveal your love to us. We're made in your image. We are made to love. Help that be the overriding emotion right now. And show us how to love those who are hard to love too. In Jesus' name, amen. So, I ask God to show me my own emotions and desires about the future of this relationship. What are my great concerns or fears about this relationship? What are my great desires for it? My hopes and dreams for it? If you desire something in particular about the person you're thinking about, or a group of people, it could be with a family, then ask God for it now. Let's just return to this present moment right now. Has my perspective shifted at all? Or have your emotions changed regarding the issues today? Have you had a new thought about this relationship? What are you called to do tomorrow with this person? Are you called to call somebody? Is God saying, write them a letter? Is God saying, give him a ring? Is God saying, say sorry? Or say, you're forgiven? What's he put on your heart? You don't have to tell us. It's between you and God and this other person. Just ask him about it now. Lord, thank you for people's honesty. Thank you for people's love for their fathers. I know that many people have hard, difficult or distant relationships with dads or mums or parent figures of some kind. But Lord, I'm praying now that whoever people have been thinking of, however distant people feel from their family, Lord, I pray that you bring a closeness through relationship, through communication. Warm people's hearts where they need warming and encourage those who need encouraging to get in touch, to ask for forgiveness, to forgive, to love. If another day needs not go by and people need to act on it, I pray, Lord, that you would be so powerfully in their mind that it's the first thought when they wake up in the morning. Lord, please send your Holy Spirit to guide us through these times. And we thank you so much for this day. We thank you for so many things, this ability to have this prayer time as well. Thank you, Jesus, for your love for us and your sacrifice. In your holy name, amen. Hi, Judith. Okay. Well, Richard, hi. I'm not sure who your friends are in Torquay, but I will pass your message on to Ed as well. I'm sure he'll see this. You could tag him. Just put Ed Williams in this and it should come up. It's lovely that you joined us, mate. Thank you. Hey, Judith. Amen. Oh, Virginia said she still misses her dad with the Lord, but it's still hard. Magdalena, tomorrow will be a difficult day. And your father left when you were a small girl and he doesn't keep in touch with you. I'm so sorry. You know what? Your Father in heaven loves you. And he knows you well. And I know that's painful. I'm so sorry. But spend time with God tomorrow. He's your heavenly Father and he loves you. Yeah. Okay, guys. Well, I'm not going to go on too long. So sending much love. God be with you. And tomorrow morning, we've got our service at 10 o'clock with Sam. And it's Father's Day. So I hope you get to talk to, pray for, think of, look at photos of dads or people that to you were your dad. And I pray you have a really good evening and a restful night. And the seagulls don't keep you awake with all their babies, because there's a lot of seagull babies going on at the moment. Okay, thanks guys, bye, love you lots, bye.